Okay, Michael, do you have an answer?
I have an answer indeed.
Okay, what's the answer?
Okay, maybe I don't have an answer indeed, but I have the ability to compute one.
Okay.
I'm doing some math.
So why don't you walk me through the math you're doing?
I got 0.32776.
That is correct, Michael.
Woohoo. That was trickier than I thought.
Okay, well, show me what you did.
All right, so the first thing I did is I said, okay, well, this is not so hard because from the start state, if I execute up, up, right, 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 each of those things works the way it's supposed to do independently with probability 0.8.
Yep.
And so 0.8 raised to the fifth power gives me the probability that that entire sequence will work as intended.
Exactly. And what is 0.8 to the fifth? Do you know?
32,768 with a decimal point in front of it because, you know, powers of 2.
Wow. That is correct. But I noticed that 32768 is not 32776.
No, they differ by a little smidge.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what occurred to me next, is there any way that you could have ended up falling into the goal from that sequence of commands, not following the intended path? So since actions can have unintended consequences, as they often do,
mm-hmm.
I was going to ask, okay, so if I go up in the first step, there's a probability 0.1 that I'll actually go to the right.
Yep.
From there, if I go up, there's a 10% probability that I'll actually go to the right.
Mm-hmm.
From there, the next thing I do is take the right action, but that can actually go up with some probability, 0.1.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then another 0.1 to get to for the next right action to actually cause an up to happen.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, that last right might actually execute correctly and bring me into the goal. So I could go underneath the barrier instead of around the barrier with that same sequence. It just isn't very likely.
Okay, well, how unlikely is it?
All right, so I did 0.1 times 0.1 times 0.1 times 0.1 times 0.8.
So the 0.1 to the 4 times 0.8, and that's right. So this is the probability that the four of these go wrong. In fact, exactly the first four go wrong, and the last one goes right.
Right.
And that's equal to some very, very small number, and when you add it up, you end up with 0.32776. So in fact, that's equal to 0008. And that's how you get that number, and that's correct. And you'll notice that this this sequence happens to work out to be the second sequence that we had optioned for.
Yeah, the other thing that took us to the goal, right, was exactly the probability of executing that action, executing that sequence of transitions given the first command.
Yeah, and I think it would work the other way, too. No, it wouldn't quite work the other way. If you had done the sequence right, right, what is it, right, right, up, up, right?
Yeah.
In order for that one to work out, it had 0.8 to the 5 of working, and for it to work out wrong but work out right, the right would have to send you up, and then the ups would have to send you right. So it would actually work out to be the same.
Yeah.
So no matter which of the two sequences you came up with, they would have the same probability of succeeding.
Neat.
Nice. That's actually kind of cool. So good job, Michael. Very good job on the quiz. A lot of people forget this part. And in fact, if you forgot that part and got just this part right, we actually let you pass. But it was wrong.
I was kind of expecting you to get it wrong, but I'm glad you got it right too.
Thank you, Michael. I appreciate your faith in me. I wrote the quiz. Actually, I stole this from a book, whose little words are now showing up in front of you exactly where you can go through the details of this quiz. Okay. All right, Michael. So you might ask yourself why I brought this up. And the reason I brought this up is because what we did in the first case where we just came up with the sequence up, up, right, 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 is we sort of planned out what we would do in a world where nothing could go wrong. But once we introduce this notion of uncertainty, this randomness, this stochasticity, we have to do something other than work out in advance what the right answer is and then just go. We have to do something a little bit more complicated. Either we have to try to execute these and then every once in a while see if we've drifted away and then replan, come up with a new sequence wherever it is we happen to end up, or we have to come up with some way to incorporate all of these uncertainties and probabilities so that we never really have to rethink what to do in case something goes wrong. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to introduce a framework that's very common that people use as a way of capturing this stuff, capturing these uncertainties directly. Okay?
Hmm.
You ready?
Yeah.
Excellent.